You probably don't recognize me. I've had a lot of plastic surgery. I used to be a professional wrestler. And I would trick my opponents. I would lull them into a false sense of security. The first few rounds, I would let them beat me mercilessly. Then I would, while lying on the canvas, feigning a knockout, I'd say, pull my finger. And they would. And then I would take a terrible revenge. However, I'm going to talk about that tonight. I'll talk about that after the break. But first of all, let's tell you why you should be watching the show tonight. Because it's free. And I don't know if you noticed, but there's a depression going on. Anybody say recession? I'm like, no. Recession is like, I don't know if we can afford that, honey. That's recession. This is different. I don't know if you've noticed, but this is like, what? I'm scared. I might have to go back to wrestling in order to make ends meet. And I'm worried. Big guest tonight, Sam Jackson is here. Death Cab For Cutie are here. Come back.
Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I am your host, TV Speak Ferguson. Please now relax. That's fine. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. You have earned your $7. Please sit down, relax. And we'll add the rest on using a machine. I know, now the blogosphere is going to go, oh, they do use a machine. If we used a machine, I'd be funnier. Anyway, it's a great day for America. It actually is a great day for America. Is it, Craig? Oh, yes, it is. And I'll tell you why. Kim Kardashian has announced she's releasing a sexy calendar for 2009. Hooray! You got a picture of Kim there in January, and then February through December is just the rest of her ass. No, better not. Anyway, good news from India.
Really?
Good news from India? Yeah, well, actually, in India, a New Delhi woman gave birth to a baby girl. She was 70 years old. Not the baby girl, the woman. This is the oldest woman to have a child since Demi Moore had Ashton. This is a record breaker. Oh, Ashton grew up fast, didn't he, little Ashton? Grew up fast, now he's in that camera commercial. Where he goes around being cool. Douche. Anyway, What? Hey, I'd never say that. I like working in Hollywood. There's a supermarket, though, in New Jersey has refused to put the name of a toddler on a birthday cake. It was a terrible... You know what the toddler's name was? This is true, and I can see their point. Because the name of the toddler, I'm not kidding, is Adolf Hitler Campbell. Kid, Adolf Hitler. I mean, come on. This is devastating to his parents, Genghis Campbell and Osama bin Campbell, who are terribly upset. What the hell is wrong? Do you hate your kid or something?
Anyway, well, I'll tell you what I really want to talk about. There's a movie opening today that I'm very excited about. It's called The Wrestler. I really want to see it. Right now, it's only in a few cities, but it opens everywhere in the next few weeks. It stars Mickey Rourke, who was a huge star about 20 years ago, then he disappeared. And people say he doesn't look the same now. He's got long blonde hair, he's had a lot of plastic surgery. Do we have a picture of Mickey Rourke? No. Oh, come on. That's not Mickey Rourke, that's Kenny Rogers. Can we see a... Give me a real picture of Mickey Rourke, please. Yeah, this is Mickey in it. I know. I know. Now, like, to show you how much he has changed, did we see a picture of Mickey Rourke about 20 years ago? See, wasn't he cute? I like Mickey Rourke, actually. I'm a fan of Mickey Rourke. He's one of these people who carries a little dog wherever he goes. There's a picture of him at a movie premiere. Look, there he is. Look, he's got his little dog. That's what Paris Hilton's going to look like in about 5 weeks. Look at that. What is that little yappy thing Paris Hilton carries around? What's it called? Nicole Richie. Oh, shut up. It's a joke. I'm only kidding. Anyway, this movie, The Wrestler, it's a small independent movie. People say Mickey Rourke could win an Oscar for this. Now, which is unusual, because usually the independent award-winning movies are the sensitive period dramas, where everyone talks like this, you know. I say, my trousers are on fire. Kiss me, father. You don't understand me. I'm excited to see a movie like that about wrestling. That'll be awesome. I say, Lord Percy. I beseech you not to smash me over the head with a folding chair. Apparently this movie, The Wrestler, exposes some hard truths, because it turns out that wrestling is fake. Oh, no! I haven't been this shocked since I found out Clay Aitken was gay. Now, the WWE wrestling, very popular these days. The WWE used to be called the WWF, but they had to change their name so people wouldn't confuse them with the World Wildlife Fund. That's true. Now, a wild animal and a wrestler are very different, of course. One's a creature who lives in the woods and marks his territory by peeing on it. You can finish it yourself. Anyway, there. A lot of professional wrestlers, they'll go on to do great things. Remember Jesse the Body Ventura? It was nice to see him escape the world of cheap shots and name-calling and dirty double crosses. And now he's done with politics, he might go back to wrestling. I love how the wrestlers have got the signature moves. Like, you know, like Chris Jericho used to have that thing called the Walls of Jericho. Did we have a picture of the Walls of Jericho? There, yeah, oh, wow. Whoa. The Balls of Jericho. We cut it out.
We cut it out.
Will we cut it out? Oh, will we? No. Anyway, we cut that out. Anyway, I have a... I've got... Things have gone a little crazy right here tonight. Now, I've got my signature move as well, my signature wrestling move. It's the Ferguson pull my finger. They never see it coming. Silent but deadly. Anyway, then. Now, wrestling, of course, was invented in ancient Greece. It was two young men were stripped naked, rubbed themselves in oil, rolled around on a floor. Somebody came in and they said, we've just invented a sport. And... Now, listen, I'm going to take a controversial stance here. I don't think wrestling really is a sport. No. Don't you owe me? You're not Vince McMahon. Well, the state of New Jersey ruled that wrestling and their thing, they said that wrestling is not a legitimate sport. They said that, you know, and if the state of New Jersey says you're a bit shady, then you're a bit shady. And they know about shady in New Jersey. They do. That's right, I'm talking to you, Mafia. What are you gonna do? Wrestling isn't a sport. It's as much of a sport as hockey. What? What? Oh, that's right. I'm saying something that you don't actually secretly agree with. We have to take a break while I get fired, and then we'll be right back.
And now, a Sean Connery holiday memory.
Well, tell Spielberg he can kiss my ass. Christmas 1998. I had the tallest Christmas tree of anyone in the United States. It was the tree in the New York's Rockefeller Center. I was living under it at the time. They booted me out, but I left a couple of presents under the tree for the Department of Sanitation. That's right, I crapped there.
Now, listen, I want to make an apology. I want to make an apology to the NHL. Of course, hockey is a sport. And the views expressed by me are none of the views expressed by the mighty CBS Corporation or any of its affiliated companies. Do you know what else isn't a sport? Darts. See, where I grew up in Britain, darts were considered athletics. People would, you'd watch on TV, people, the darts players would drink beer while they were playing the darts. An American athlete would never do that. I mean, Babe Ruth was known for, well, but he would never actually be drinking a beer while he was at bat. And when I was a kid, one of the most popular athletes, a dart player in Scotland, was a guy called Jockey Wilson. He was the Michael Jordan of darts, except he weighed 500 pounds and he had one tooth. He's like Jabba the Hutt. I'm not getting.
Oh, darts.
It's true. Do we have a picture of Jockey Wilson? That's him. That's really him.
That magnificent athlete.
You notice how he's glistening? Let me show you again. Do you know how he's glistening? That's because throwing the dart is exhausting. It made him sweat more than Sarah Palin taking a geography test. That's how much it made him sweat. Is there anyone I haven't insulted tonight? If I haven't insulted you, email me. I'll get to you. You know, when I was a kid, we'd watch the darts on TV, and the announcer would say, "There's Jockey Wilson, the magnificent athlete, calm and collected." And I'm like, "Of course he's calm and collected. He just drank half a keg of Guinness." Anyway, I can't be mucking around with this. I've got to do the email. Do we even have time for emails tonight, do we?
Oh, it's time to answer an email.
Yeah, that's right. Take that, legacy of punk rock. All right, this is from Bobby in St. Petersburg, in Florida, I'm guessing. Won't be the other one in Russia. That would be Robertovich. Bobby in St. Petersburg says, "Do you think there are people that are robots? If so, do they know they are robots?" Bobby, you're smoking too much pot. Of course, I could just be a robot. Who knows? All right. This is from Jason in Louisville. Louisville's in Kentucky. And you don't say Louisville, or they'll know you're from out of town. You gotta say Louisville. That's how they pronounce it. Just try and say the word Louisville and then slow yourself down. So that it's like you're going at maybe a tenth of your normal speed and you go... Anyway, Jason in Louisville says... Dear Craig, have you ever wanted to tell someone they had bad breath? What did you do? It's a tricky thing, bad breath, but there's an old vaudeville routine that will help you with it. What you do is that you lean in close to the person with bad breath and say, do you know you have acute halitosis? And they'll say, well, thank you very much. And you're covered. All right, we got to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. I'm sorry, I have to be very careful. There seems to be a thin film of eggnog all over the floor. God, I hope it's eggnog. Shut up! My first guest tonight is in is a great big movie star. He's in The Spirit in theatres December the 25th. Take a look at this. Please welcome Samuel L. Jackson, everyone. Fantastic.
Thank you. It was an amazing amount of fun to be that crazy every day. I mean, Frank Miller let me do some spectacularly off the chain kind of scenery chewing because this character has actually never been seen. Even in the comic book, he was only a pair of gloves.
So you could
do what you want.
Because you're usually known for your restrained, very quiet performances. But this one,
it's a different thing for me because you know it's the award season and all those other very 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 serious and important works of cinema are being released right now.
Absolutely,
it's my opportunity to be the alternate programming.
Yes, that's right. You're like the lingerie bowl.
Exactly.
Right.
You know, instead of going to see Benjamin Button, you can go see The Spirit. Yeah. You can go see Brad Pitt as an ugly baby.
Yeah.
Or
who wants to see that?
As a buckwild killer.
Hey! Yeah. You're right.
There you go.
That's what people want. Have you ever counted
But what I
want
to know is...
What?
Did that 70-year-old lady have Benjamin Button? Because you stopped that story.
I know, that's true.
I was right in the middle of that story, and you just said a 70-year-old lady had a baby.
Yeah.
You can't let it go with that, man.
Well,
we want to know
really, it wasn't
who
really
the baby daddy. The dude from Slumdog Millionaire, right?
I was in India. I was lonely. I don't know. I think she won me over with the smell of peppermints.
Space for rent. Yeah. It was the lure of space for rent.
I think
you got some wrestling problems coming up.
No. There's gonna be trouble.
It's gonna be.
Yeah. All right, you take that half, and I'll take that half.
Yeah, because if you do go back to the WWE, I want to go with you.
Let's do it. Yeah. What will your wrestling name be? I've got my signature move, the pull my finger. Could have the...
I had the booger puller when I was in there.
Yeah, the booger puller.
Booger puller.
Yeah.
Just run my fingers up their nose, twist. It's a submission hole.
Nice. It's booger puller. It's B-U-G-G-A-P-U-L-L-A.
Booger puller.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Nice. Very nice.
want to ask.
That's a British nasty thing.
That's
though,
yeah, that is. If you do that in Britain, that's good.
In Britain, you get beat down for that in Britain, right?
Yeah. Let's never do it in Britain. You can't do. Now, listen. I wanted to ask you a very serious question about.
Okay,
you.
All right.
Have you ever counted the amount of times you've killed somebody in a film, like in your entire career? Because it must be thousands.
No, not thousands. I've been in the hundreds, though, probably.
Yeah. I don't think so.
I actually think about the number of times that I've died and how many ways I've died, but I've never thought about how many people I killed.
Well, how many times have you died, then?
Oh, wow. I stopped counting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because when you're a young actor, when you're a young black actor, that's what you do. You know, you pick up a script.
It's true, man. It's true. Hey, did you ever see that movie? There was this movie that had Sir Anthony Hopkins, Alec Baldwin, and a young black actor I'd never heard of, and they were in the forest, and they were getting chased by a bear.
The bear.
Yeah. And I'm thinking, I do not want to be the young black actor with these two movie stars being chased by a bear in the movie. You know what's going on. Did you really?
I auditioned for that movie.
Really?
Yes, I did. Yeah, I didn't get the job, apparently.
Well,
but yeah. But I
thank your lucky stars because the young man was killed
by the
bear.
Anthony Hopkins was a writer. Alec Baldwin was this young guy having an affair with his young wife.
That's right.
And the brother was just, why was the brother even there?
They needed to feed someone to the bear. They wanted to show that the bear was aggressive.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's wrong, isn't it? Yeah. Isn't that wrong?
No, that used to be the deal. You pick up the script, read your name, find out what page you died on. You know.
That's wrong.
That was okay. It was a job.
Yeah, that's true.
I died in some good places. I used to go to Boston once a year and die on Spencer for Hire.
That's nice.
Yeah, I knew it. You know, I just go, hey, I'm dying. Spencer for Hire. Good. I'm good with that.
So did you like to? Well, the money's the same whether you die early in the movie or the show or later on, isn't
it? That's true.
Well,
one of the first movies that I lived that people would recognize me from was Coming to America. At least, you know, Eddie Murphy didn't kill me.
Yeah, that's right. That's when it started to turn around for you.
Not really.
Stay alive to the end of the movie.
Yeah, that's when
you know you're a movie star.
Just stayed alive in that scene.
Right.
It's a star. It's a place to start.
Now, listen, are you going down to the inauguration in January? I know you were a big supporter of...
I'm trying to get there.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm totally trying to be there.
It must be quite a remarkable thing because you were involved in the civil rights movement.
Back when.
Yeah.
Yeah, who would have thought?
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, back then, we were just, you know, trying to get black studies. You know, who knew we were going to have a black president?
Yeah. You know, did you campaign? Did you go ahead and do some campaigning?
Yeah, I did stuff. I did some campaigning in Texas because I was working in Louisiana, so I bounced out of Shreveport into Texas on Academy Award weekend. Actually, everybody was, you know, coming to the Academy Awards, so I was doing that. Did a lot of phone calling. You know, a lot of stuff like that.
That must be an interesting thing. You call somebody up and go, hey, it's Sam Jackson. You better vote for Obama and come around your house.
Yeah, you can hear him going, yeah, right.
Is that what you did?
You can hear him going, yeah, right.
Oh, yeah. They wouldn't believe it.
And then you got to do something like recite Ezekiel 25:17, you know, and then they go, damn, it's him. I like that movie.
Wow. Yeah,
that's really funny. I like that movie.
Do you still remember that Bible passage from that movie? That is one of the scariest things in
Come on.
I'm telling you, that's scary. When you had that perm hair and you were doing that. Yeah. Oh, man. That was a worry.
Straight out of Compton, yeah.
Yeah. That's right, you and Travolta.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Johnny has some weird hair, too.
He did have some weird hair. Do you know, though, I think he played a guy on heroin better than anyone I've ever seen do it in my life. You know, I've seen guys on heroin, and he had that kind of, like, vacant, naughty, kind of stupid look about him. It was awesome. No, he did it really well. Don't you like that scene in the car when he's like...
Yeah, he has that, you know, John has that sense of heroin.
Hey, can you hang around?
Yes.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back with Sam Jackson, everybody. I'm here with Sam Jackson. Sam.
Yes.
What are you doing for Christmas? Where are you going?
I'm going to be here. I got relatives coming to town. Plus, you know, Sunday's my birthday, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. So,
Is it a big one? Does it have a zero or a five in it?
And a six. Yeah.
You're 650 years old?
Exactly.
Wow.
Yeah, man. No, I'll be 60 on Sunday. So.
Wow.
I'm shocked, too.
Wow.
I am absolutely shocked that I'm still around.
Well, you know? I not just that, but you look at you. You look in great shape.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'll be here. So I got folks coming here, and then I'm gonna go to the film festival in Capri.
Capri in France?
Oh man, Italy, dude.
All right.
He's a European.
You got that Sarah Palin geography thing going.
Yeah. No, they have a Capri in France. Not a lot of people know about it.
Not the strip club.
Yeah, Le Capri, it's in Paris. You go to the area.
Yeah. I've been there.
Yeah, have you been there?
I was there last week.
Really? It's awesome.
Gay Paris. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't go to the gay one. I just went to the
gay one. Yeah, you did. They got pictures of you on the wall.
You're shaming me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey,
very young pictures.
Yeah, no, they're good pictures. They're good pictures to see.
Yeah.
What are you going to do when you're in Capri, then? They're having a film festival?
I think they're giving me something. You know, I'm at that point in my career where people are giving me things because I've been in it so long. I got, like, an award from the Cinematheque a couple of weeks ago, and now I'm getting something else from this film festival.
From the Italians.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
very
from
nice.
Yeah, the Italians. Sorry. It's nice to get something from the Italians.
Yeah. They love cinema in Italy, you know.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, yeah. You know what else they love in Italy? Marijuana. Not a lot of people know that.
They got weed in Italy?
Not only they got weed, they smoke more weed per capita than Alaska.
Get out of here. Is that why they give you so much food at an Italian restaurant?
That's why the food's so good. You're like, whoa,
why the plates are like.
Yeah.
Oh.
I had no idea. I didn't know about that, but I made a movie once about marijuana, and it was a huge hit in Italy because they love marijuana, apparently.
See, I gave up everything way too soon. I stopped smoking weed like in 80 or something, you know?
It made me panicky.
It's crazy, too, because I see guys now smoke weed, man. It's like, weed must be like, how much? How much is weed, man, now?
The dude there with the goatee, that dude. Yeah, right there, you can see him, right there. That dude.
How much is weed
now? $20 is bad.
He's lying. Not hydro from what I hear. It's like $200. Like weed has like been like they cross pollinated.
Crazy.
Stuff, but I'd probably kill myself on something.
Oh yeah, you don't want to go near any of that stuff.
Right. Italian weed.
No, don't go near that.
I won't.
Too fast.
Ah.
And also they use the metric system.
That means so you can't get a pound, you have to buy what?
A kilo.
Oh. Can't afford that.
You can't afford that. No, that's a lot of weed.
Do they give you time in a metric years too for like possessing it when they catch you?
Oh yeah, yeah. But you go to an Italian jail, which is kind of like
Nah, because you know that whole Roman thing.
No, they
do that gladiator thing in Italian jails.
No. They moved on from gladiators a long time ago. I don't know where you're getting your information.
But why do they call it gladiator school here then?
Well, because what school are we talking about here?
Ferguson.
Oh, is that what they call it?
That's what they call prison here. He's going to gladiator school.
It's funny. I didn't think they could make prison sound gayer, but they just did. I've never heard that before. Mind you, I thought Capri was in France.
Well, you are a brand new American, so you haven't heard everything.
New, yeah.
You haven't heard all the catchphrases we use.
No, I've not got all of them down yet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't worry
about that.
It's coming.
Listen, happy birthday when it comes.
Thank you so much.
It's always lovely to see you. Don't see spirit. Who was it they used to have a song? Rod Stewart. used to sing that song, Sailing. And everybody used to go like that. I am sailing. Do you remember, did anyone do that, or was it just me? That's probably why I still have to stay at least 30 feet from Rod Stewart at all times. I met Rod Stewart once, actually. I'm not kidding you. And guess what? He's quite small. Anyway, I taught him my signature wrestling move. Now, what did we learn on the show tonight? Well, I'll tell you what we learned. We learned how to pronounce the name of the town Louisville in Kentucky correctly. Let's just go over it one more time. If you're going to the town of Louisville in Kentucky, you don't say, hello, it's lovely to be in Louisville. You say, I'm very happy to be in Louisville. Also, we learned that wrestling is fake. We learned that Clay Aiken is gay. We guessed that maybe Mickey Rourke has had some, you know, plastic surgery. I'm going to have it done. Look, like that. That's what I learned. Like, after the Christmas break, I'm going to be back like this. Just diet and exercise. That's what I do. Diet and exercise. Mm-hmm. Thanks. Good night, everybody.